The problem we face is that to build a new weapon system of any kind takes about 20 years from inception to delivery. So what we must do is use what we have and make it work. There are a number of options which are within already existing budgets that would hugely increase the power of this country. If we abandon Trident, double the number of astute submarines, arm them with nuclear-tipped cruise missiles, put British-built marinized Typhoons onto our new carriers, which will be there around 5 years before the famous F-35, also armed with nuclear-tipped cruise missiles, we would have a formidable ability, and we could do it at a price that would also be affordable, and it would keep factories from here to the north of England, to Scotland, and yards as far north as precise, busy as hell for the next 50 years. Are any in this party who are deeply concerned about the proposed merger of EADS and British Aerospace? And they have absolutely every right to be. The first question, which I find very confusing in this whole proposition, is that I believe that it's only a few months ago that the chairman of British Aerospace received an award for transparency and lack of corruption by the company, which I have to tell you includes the abolition of having any representatives of salesmen in any country, which is maybe why they're not selling very much. Now, the same company, the same board of directors, now think that it's a good idea to try and do a merger with EADS, who are under very close inspection by the serious fraud office concerning a contract called GPT valued at £2 billion in Saudi Arabia. Now maybe I'm reading from the wrong piece of paper, but it strikes me that this is a pretty odd state of affairs. The second is it is absolutely impossible for any respectable government to sign a deal which allows other governments to have some form of veto, i.e. France and Germany.